Man-made satellites have come a long way since the first one, Sputnik, was sent into orbit by the Soviet Union.
But Sputnik could only send beeping sounds back to Earth, so it wasn't any help for predicting the weather.
Before satellites, it was difficult to know what was happening over the ocean. The worst natural disaster in U.S. history happened when a powerful hurricane made landfall in Galveston, Texas, and no one knew it was coming. The first help did arrive in 1960 with the launch of TIROS 1, which could send grainy pictures of cloud formations back to Earth. Better than nothing, I guess.
Jump ahead to today, and the satellites we use are incredibly advanced. They're used for everything including communications, GPS, spotting things on Google Earth, to many different weather applications. This includes observing clouds, wind speeds over the oceans, volcanic ash plumes, snowpack, sandstorms in the Sahara Desert, and tracking storms so we do know when they're coming.
Now it's time to get a little bit nerdier than we already have been. Let's talk about the two main types of satellite orbits and how they work.
Polar orbiting satellites are usually found between 600 to 900 kilometers above the Earth, and as the name suggests, they orbit the poles as the Earth spins underneath them, kind of like a scanner. And because they're so close, they take the highest resolution images of the Earth's surface. The second main type are the geostationary satellites. Now these satellites are at a much higher altitude. These satellites remain fixed over one point on the Earth's surface at all times. This orbit is where many of the satellites that track weather are located, along with the satellites that bring you your favorite television shows. There are currently over 4,500 active and inactive satellites orbiting the Earth as we speak, and more are being launched every year. These spacecraft are remarkable for their ability to look beyond the scope of weather. Since they first began beaming data back almost 60 years ago, we've been building an image of our Earth and how it is changing.
Without satellites, we wouldn't be able to see these changes and how we're a part of them.